You've had a significant taste of quantum computation that included qubits, bipartite states, quantum operators, and three different quantum algorithms. Today, we extend our reach to n qubits for any number n, and introduce two algorithms that apply to those large systems. We're starting to do computation on real multi-qubit computers. The first step is to officially complete our tensor algebra and introduce notation used to talk about higher-order tensor products. So we review second-order tensors and follow that with the notation used for third order. As you can see, the sums and dimensions get large very fast. Even if we're starting with small two-dimensional spaces like H, the third-order tensors have 2 times 2 times 2, or 8 basis vectors in 8 dimensions. The only change when we go further is the notation. We can no longer write out the expressions literally, so we must resort to summation and product notation. But the concepts and rules are exactly the same as those for order 2 tensors. One just has to be careful when reading and writing the expressions. Fortunately for us, we only have to apply everything to H equals C2, so the notation settles down. All basis tensors are products of ket 0 and ket 1, and each can be described either by a sequence of 1s and 0s, or a number from 0 to 2 to the n minus 1. Looking at it for n equals 3 gives us a pretty good idea of what we're dealing with. Be sure to study that notation carefully. I'll also introduce you to a famous and powerful 3-qubit operator, the Toffoli gate. It's a generalization of the bipartite operator C0. The most important separable operator continues to be the Hadamard, even when we work in order n. We develop a formula for that gate good for any order. It's important to remember that this formula only applies to CBS kets. For general tensors, we have to extend using linearity. And by the way, the nth order Hadamard continues to act as a basis conversion operator, relating the nth order z basis to the nth order x basis. The final touch to our supersizing effort is to define the nth order oracle for Boolean functions of n classical bits. Nothing new, just more inputs. Deutsch's algorithm was more a proof of concept than anything else. It was a paltry 2 times speed-up over classical methods applied to a problem so small it hardly justifies the expense of a quantum computer. The deutsch-jozsa algorithm solves the same balance versus constant problem, but for a function of n bits. As with its little brother, it does so in only one evaluation of the oracle. Meanwhile, as the number of bits n grows, the number of evaluations needed for a classical solution is of the order 2 to the n. It's classically exponential, yet quantum constant, or depending on how you count, quantum linear. Either way, it's an exponential speedup. There's a minor problem with the analysis, though. It's not quite fair. If we allow a minuscule probability of error, that is, we consider a classical solution which is probabilistic rather than deterministic, we can find a constant classical solution. So the quantum algorithm doesn't seem that compelling after all. That's okay, though. We're moving in the right direction, and with the very same circuit, we arrive at an algorithm by Bernstein and Vazirani that solves a problem which is classically linear, even probabilistically so. Meanwhile, the quantum solution only requires one evaluation of the oracle. It's constant. This is a true speedup, even if not exponential. It represents the first fair and practical separation between quantum and classical computing. And that wraps up all of our elementary quantum algorithms. The remainder of this course is going to be devoted to two advanced algorithms, Simon's period finding and Shor's factoring. But those two are quite advanced, so we'll want to spend a little more time upping our game. In the final section of today's chapter, we begin that process by generalizing the Born rule to apply to any number of qubits. You'll see what I mean when you do the reading. Right now, you're doing pretty impressive quantum computing and breathing some rarefied air. But let's not stop. Our ascent continues.